Hi, Bob Hochmuth here, University of Florida IFAS Extension. I'm a regional specialized agent housed at the North Florida Research and Education Center, Suwannee Valley, just outside of Live Oak. I want to continue on our virtual trolley tour for watermelons here and talk about another research program that we have here. This is going to be about diseases of watermelons. I'm standing in the middle of a trial where we are evaluating powdery mildew control measures, management measures. And so powdery mildew is a fungus disease that, if you go back many years ago, a couple of decades, it was rare for us to find powdery mildew in watermelons. Not rare for us to find powdery mildew in squash and cucumbers and other things in gardens around your area, perhaps. But in watermelons, it was not a typical disease. We have seen a great increase of problems with powdery mildew in the last 10 to 15 years. In fact, I would say that today it's almost one of our most dependable diseases to appear every year during the watermelon season here in North Florida. Powdery mildew first appears when you see it as sort of a yellow splotchy area on the leaf. On the upper leaf surface, and when it begins to infect the leaf, you take that leaf and turn it upside down, and then you would be able to see the white or grayish spores that would be on the undersurface of the leaf underneath those yellow splotchy areas. And without it being controlled, it basically will take over the field and shut down the ability of the watermelon plant to be able to do the normal things that it would do with photosynthesis. It destroys the ability of that leaf to be able to photosynthesize and make energy for the plant. It also will result in leaves that will tend to desiccate and die and expose the watermelons, which makes them much more prone to sunburning without the good leaf cover. We would typically manage powdery mildew with a series of different fungicides, spray programs that would help us to manage the program. And that's what's going on here. We have about a dozen different application treatments. Once a week, we would be implementing some type of a management strategy in these 12 different plots here at the center. Many of those are weekly preventative applications of different fungicides. Some of them are evaluating fungicides that are new and maybe in the future would become labeled for watermelon, but perhaps currently are not labeled. So we would use our current strategies with some new products that are coming onto the market. And then the other part that's interesting on the management strategy here is that we are measuring leaf wetness through a remote site within the plot. Leaf wetness is a good indicator, perhaps, of when we have the highest risk for the fungus to become a problem in the watermelon crop. So we're using the leaf wetness data to trigger when we would implement certain sprays. So that's a whole nother component of this particular strategy. Otherwise, we would just be doing them on a weekly basis. But can we reduce the number of applications by using something like a leaf wetness indicator to trigger when a certain spray program would be initiated? The other trial that we have going on here at the center would be a cooperative project with one of our industry cooperators, that's Corteva, and that trial focuses on another specific fungal organism known as gummy stem blight. So we're focused here on this particular stop on powdery mildew, but just wanted to let you know that we do also have some other research that is ongoing looking at similar kinds of control measures for gummy stem blight. Disease management overall is one of the highest expenses for our watermelon growers in the state of Florida. We just have a series of conditions that make it conducive for a lot of these diseases to become problems. And so every year has to be a high level of investment to minimize the losses from diseases such as powdery mildew, gummy stem blight, downy mildew, and others. So we're hoping to get good results here that'll be able to help our growers in the future to be able to best manage powdery mildew in their own commercial fields.